pendaftaran dan akan memudahkan lagi dan menjimatkan masa saya lah.
Pagi tadi kita memberi sedikit teaser mengenai Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Are you guys okay?
Perfect.
Huh? Okay, is the ground here, is the platform okay?
Oh, not too bad.
Huh? Not too bad. Because good. Bunyi je dentam dentum saya pun. Takut juga kalau ada sebarang mungkin kecederaan ke apa. Tak ada. Okay. Dan juga sebenarnya kita ada Ed Samad. Ed, sebab sini Ed, macam mic tu tak. Okay, depan sikit. Kita semua ke depan sikit.
Okay, kita semua.
Okay. Selalu kita tengok Ed Samad ni dalam bidang muzik. Macam mana boleh terlibat dalam Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ini? Boleh bagi sedikit pengenalan.
Saya memang berminat dengan Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Saya berminat dengan gaya hidup yang sihat. Dan Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ni memberi gaya hidup yang sihat, tubuh badan yang sihat dan juga seni pertahankan diri yang sangat efektif untuk mereka yang badan kecil, badan besar dan sebagainya. Yeah. Sebenarnya saya sangat besar hati hari ini. Saya selalu datang atas muzik. Tapi hari ini kerana ni lagi saya rasa macam benda yang betul-betul saya suka sangat
dalam minat betul.
Dan saya nak introduce.
Kita nak perkenalkan.
Ni saya punya chief instructor, Marco Escobar daripada Brazil. Dia ialah seorang bekas pemenang Abu Dhabi Combat Competition.
ADCC. Satu pertandingan grappling yang amat prestigious sekali.
Sangat prestigious di dunia.
Okay. Yeah. Saya tengok dia pun macam I feel a bit, you know, intimidated. But just the look at the uniform and that black belt around your waist.
Sebenarnya saya secara peribadi merasakan kita di Malaysia ni sangat-sangat patutnya rasa berhormatlah kerana Marcos sanggup datang ke negara kita dan mempelopori Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Di dunia, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ialah masyarakat yang paling pesat berkembang sekali.
Okay.
Dan banyak competition kita telah menunjukkan Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu telah menunjukkan yang ia sangat efektif. Ia sangat boleh menguasai pelbagai-bagai mix martial art.
Jadi
dengan kehadiran dia di sini, saya sangat besar hati. Saya rasa saya nak ada di sini nak ajak ramai orang lagi untuk sama-sama dengan kita dalam Brazil.
Dan sebelahnya
Ini saudara Aaron Goh.
Okey, saya sebelah sini lah.
Boleh. Saya Aaron Goh dan saya adalah manager untuk Marcos Escobar BJJ. Jadi saya tolong dia untuk basically relationship lah dengan the locals. Itulah responsibility saya.
Okay. Now Marcos, I feel a bit intimidated.
Jangan.
Okay. How long have you been here in Malaysia?
I've been in Malaysia for 5 years.
5 years. Okay. What brought you to Malaysia in the first place?
I'm also a fitness instructor.
Okay.
And so I teach some classes like body pop or performance classes. But my background is all about martial arts.
Right.
So I just felt I kept doing my thing here, bringing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu to Malaysia, something new, and It's also a very good workout.
Yeah.
Not only for people that wants to learn martial arts, but for people that wants to get fit.
Yeah.
So
okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying now.
I did a bit of reading on the origins of jiu-jitsu. But can you tell our audience on the origins of?
Yeah, the origins of jiu-jitsu. All right. When I first came to Brazil, Japanese Count Koma went to Brazil and he met some Carlos Gracie. Mm-hmm. All right. And he taught some art of the Japanese jiu-jitsu to Carlos Gracie. Uh-huh. And Carlos taught his brothers that very well know around the world as the Gracie family. Mm-hmm. And they developed more, they introduced more leverage to the game. Mm-hmm. All right. So because they were very skinny, not so strong, so they had to introduce more leverage so they could overcome bigger opponents.
Yeah.
And then they named the Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, and we came around the world, was named Brazilian
Jiu-Jitsu. Yeah. Okay, Aaron, saya nak tanya, kenapa Aaron boleh memilih Jiu-Jitsu ini? Ataupun Aaron pun memang ada skill dalam taekwondo dan karate dan yang lainnya?
Soalan yang amat baik sekali. Actually, saya memang tak ada background martial art. Saya tak ada background martial art. Kat sekolah pun tak pernah main bola. Memang kaki bangku lah. So, I've never been athletic. Tapi, I found that Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, dia sesuatu yang tidak kira awak dalam athletic shape macam mana pun.
Okay.
You can easily pick up sebab konsep dia, konsep dia is a smaller, weaker opponent.
Mm-hmm.
And most Asians are small.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can take on and using leverage, as can be seen tadi dalam demo, defeat a larger and stronger opponent.
Yeah, okay.
Itulah Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Itulah asas dia.
So usually like, okay, can you guys just show some basic movements jiu-jitsu. Okay.
Nak tengok macam mana?
The basic movements lah. Kalau bayangkan kalau seorang itu baru. Terlibat dalam jiu-jitsu, if a person is new, okay, what are some of the basic movements that you would teach that person?
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
Let's go down first. The first thing I'm going to show is then how to behave. For example, this is very common, and you're gonna see this a lot for self-defense as well.
Uh-huh.
Right, very common that people are very scared nowadays about, especially ladies, about rape cases or.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, if you have a bigger guy like me, I'm bigger than Aaron. Uh-huh. All right, I'm telling you here.
Uh-huh.
The first thing that I teach someone is how they behave on the floor, how can they move around.
Uh-huh.
Let's say have someone attacking you here, to choke you here.
Yeah.
If they don't know how to move on the ground, it's very hard. So first thing they need to learn how to use the hips to move around.
Uh-huh.
And they need to know how to use the legs to create some distance.
Mm.
So you're gonna just open distance from me. Oh, look how he used the legs.
Right,
So I cannot attack him from here.
Uh-huh.
I can even try, but from here where he is now, he can kick my face if it's a self-defense situation.
Yeah.
Or he can just create leverage to reverse the position. All he's gonna, what he's doing now is he's looking at my legs.
Uh-huh.
And he's gonna try to put me down, and he's gonna come on top.
Right. Okay.
All right. So it's easily adapted for self-defense as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about principle of hooks and leverage.
Uh-huh.
So he doesn't need to be bigger than me.
Yeah. Okay.
But he has the skills to try to overcome a situation.
Okay.
So basically, it's like learn how to move on the ground because once we stand up, it's quite easy for us to understand what to do because we usually walk, but once we go for a situation on the ground, what do we do?
Yeah,
So basically, we teach first the beginners how to create mobility here, how to behave on the ground, so he can easily like adapt. If he doesn't have the gi, for example, he can adapt the arms to flip, to go around. So here, he cannot do anything with me.
Mm.
How are you going to punch me from here?
Yeah.
He doesn't have the legs. He's down already.
Okay.
So we basically just prepare. The first step in our club is improve the beginner's stamina.
Right.
Right? Because even for self-defense, it's really important to have, require at least a minimum fitness level.
Uh-huh.
Otherwise, you're going to feel the adrenaline and, sweat.
I see in just a few moves and I can see like you're really sweating and really takes a lot of energy out of you and the lights as well.
So the second step after they improve the stamina a little bit, all right, you're going to start showing them the basics to create a foundation, how to move, how to apply the grips, how to posture, and then we're going to start nailing the techniques and they get into the game.
Yeah. Okay, Ed, saya nak tanya.
Yeah.
Dah sampai peringkat mana dan berapa banyak
saya masih lagi di peringkat permulaan. Saya latar belakang saya memang ada taekwondo, saya buat Muay Thai. Dan umur saya sekarang semakin dewasa kan.
Berapa tu?
42. So umur saya makin dewasa, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu ni memberi banyak leverage kepada usia saya. Itulah yang untuk mengikut statistik, kebanyakan pergaduhan akan berakhir dalam clinch, yeah. dan di lantai. Macam Marcos cakap, apabila di lantai, kita tak tahu apa. Saya tumbuk pun tak boleh, tendang pun tak boleh. Yeah. Jadi kalau mereka yang mahir dalam grappling ni, advantage kepada mereka. Dan pada usia saya dah susah sikit nak lompat tendang orang kan. Ini ialah efficient lah.
Yeah. Itu tadi Aaron, saya rasa antara yang paling perbezaan dia kalau taekwondo karate, that it's more of a stand upper kind of a martial arts. Yes. Yang striking. Ini is like and striking. Yeah. Yang ni is like groundwork kan.
Sebab ramai orang tak sedar, you know, kita tengok cerita Hollywood, right? And in Hollywood a fight starts, you know, very nicely. But in real life, okay, bila you know, when there's a misunderstanding, kan? A fight doesn't happen like in Hollywood, very nice. It happens, boom, just like that. Right. Next thing you know, all right, you're on the ground already. Hmm. Kita dah kat lantai, macam mana? Kadang-kadang macam even a robbery attempt. Next thing you know, boom, kita dah jatuh. That's how it is. That's how life is. So how do we defend ourselves? Macam mana?
Yeah.
So it's a different martial art. It's a very efficient martial art for, you know, self-defense.
Yeah. Okay, akhir sekali, Ed. Kalau mereka, saya rasa mungkin ramai yang dalam memang minat dalam
seni bertahan
diri ini mungkin berminat untuk terus stir dengan dalam jiu-jitsu ini dengan Ed dan juga Marcos. Bagaimana agaknya boleh terus stir?
Kita ada website kita dan phone number. Aaron, boleh?
For those who are interested, diorang boleh visit kita punya website. Website kita orang www.escobarbjj.com.
Okay.
Alright, kat sana ada alamat, ada email dan ada nombor kontak saya. Kelas pertama percuma. So come, try.
Okay.
Nothing to lose.
Cuba. Okay, cuba. Itu dia. Tertera di skrin www.escobarbjj.com. Okay, ya, penerbit betul. Saya kata mungkin saya boleh mencuba beberapa move tapi saya takkan mencuba.
Kalau cuba ingin lagi. Kalau mencuba ingin lagi.
Okay, mungkin nanti di masa
datang.
Bukan di sini. Okay, thank you very much Marcos, Ed Samad dan juga Aaron dan juga kalau penonton kalau berminat itu dia escobarbjj.com dan okay, tengok ni sama 42 tahun penulis lirik dan juga pengamal pada art. Top guy. Betul, ada satu endorsement tu.
Terima kasih. Kalau Marcos cakap macam tu, saya kembang.
Okay. Terima kasih diucapkan kepada tetamu kita semua. Thank you very much. Okay, dan seterusnya kita berehat seketika. Tapi sebelum ini kita ada artis jemputan Ramlah Ram. Terus dia bersama kami dalam MHI.